somewhere else, but this is where we found ourselves. Welcome to the local show, people you work with, people you know.
Welcome to another edition of The Local Show here on Grassroots Community Network. I'm Eric Scarvin, your host. Thank you so much for joining us this week, where each week we feature fantastic, inspirational locals. And I do mean that with all my heart today. I'm actually welcoming back a friend of mine, John O'Donohue, to the show. Good to see you again, buddy.
Thanks, Eric.
And a first-time guest, Will. Yeah. We'll give you the long arm. Good thing both of us are long and lean. Will Chesner, welcome to the show, buddy.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thanks for being here. And you guys are both involved in a great mission that's going to happen to the Philippines. And you've created an organization called the Aspen Friends of the Philippines. So, John, give us a little bit of background, because we did have you on the show, I guess it was about a year ago, and you guys went over to the Philippines helping people on the ground. Can you give people a little more background on kind of your group and what you guys are up to?
Yeah, nine of us last year, last September, from St. Mary's Catholic Church in Aspen. Nine of us traveled to Tacloban in the Philippines, where Super Typhoon Yolanda hit in November of 2013,
right.
The biggest storm to ever make landfall in recorded history. So the needs were great there, and we saw that when we were there last September. So we were helping a lot of people do a lot of different things. We partnered with Mother Teresa's Sisters, the Missionaries of Charity.
Okay.
So there are partners there on the ground. And I was back there in May also on a school supply mission, and we put over 1,300 kids into school this year with school supplies, uniforms, backpacks.
Incredible.
And then we're going again with nine of us in 2 weeks from St. Mary's again.
That Will. Is so cool. And Will, you're joining in for this trip. And like, Will, what was like the appeal for you? What drew you to this?
I don't know. I just wanted to do something different. I've never really done much community service. I don't really know what drew me to this one, but something happened and I just felt like doing it. I don't know.
Yeah, well, we were talking a little bit before the show that you had seen John, I think, do a presentation.
Oh, yeah.
And you saw that presentation, and there must have been something that sparked
some interest. Yeah. I just remember that video was just incredible. It just showed me, like, what it would feel like to be there and just what it feels like to help other people that are less fortunate.
Right. And we're going to actually show, I think it's the same video on the show today, John, where you're in the Philippines, Tacloban.
That's right.
And you were at a mission, but also there was like, what is it called? The Home for the Dying? I mean, these are really serious needs.
The sisters have two places in their compound that we assist them with. One is an orphanage. They have about 25 children living in the orphanage. It's called the House of Joy.
Okay.
And that's really what it is. It's not a Charles Dickens type orphanage where it's depressing and frightening. It's actually a really great place full of love, and we support that. And then right across the alley, basically, the sisters have the House of Peace, which is approximately 25 elderly, blind, crippled, just people who are destitute and abandoned,
okay.
who they would be really in big trouble if the sisters weren't there to help them. So we help the sisters help them.
Right, and on this video that we're gonna see later on in the show, you guys are actually handing out supplies on the ground. These kids going off to school. So, I mean, talk a little bit about like what these supplies are and what they mean, you know, to these kids.
Well, without basic school supplies, kids cannot attend school, and that includes a uniform. So they actually have a really great educational system there, but it's kind of strict, and a uniform is part of it. And honestly, quite a few families just can't afford the uniform.
Wow.
And the school supplies. So, we only raised maybe about $6,000 for school supplies on this last mission, but a little money in the Philippines goes a long ways.
Right.
So with the sisters shopping at a school supply warehouse, we were able to buy uniforms, backpacks, you name it, pens, pencils, notebooks for 1,328 kids, it turned out to be.
That's unbelievable. So,
and then to distribute it all over the course of 3 days in various poor communities.
Well, and what was interesting is you fly there. I mean, this is hands-on. You fly there, you go shopping, and then you go to the actual distribution location. So you're involved in pretty much all that.
Right.
From start to finish.
Yeah, I promised everybody that 100% of their money is going to go for what we say.
Right.
So I'm taking the money there in my pocket, basically exchanging it, doing the shopping and the distribution. So Yeah, we can guarantee we're doing what we're saying we're doing.
And you have good accountants because you have two nuns literally with calculators
yeah.
right there making sure everything's dialed in on the numbers.
A quick amazing story about that shopping that you might see a little of it in the video is when we exchanged the money, we ended up with 268,000 pesos. That was our budget. So that's that sounds like a lot. It's like $5,800.
Okay.
And when we shopped, when we were done, the sisters had 2 pesos left over.
Wow.
So which is like 1/20th of a penny.
Oh
and
my gosh.
It was like, how did you do that? It was really, it was amazing. So,
with the sisters sharpening their pencils and they are right to it.
And their calculators.
They are just, that is so cool. Yeah. That is so cool. Well, guys, we're going to take a quick break. We got so much to get to. You have an awesome fundraiser coming up on August 25th. We're going to talk about that. We're going to see the video of you guys from your first mission. But first, we want to take just a quick break. We do want to thank our underwriters that make the series happen this summer. We've got Aspen Square, Ajax Tavern, Element 47, Dagger Fitness, The Original Leaf, Sundog Athletics, and we'll go to a quick message. Oh, and Pickens County Landfill. Let's not forget, and we've got a show coming up in a couple weeks with Jack from Pickens County Landfill. Thank you guys so much for supporting the series this summer. We'll take a quick break. We only have one break on the show, you guys. 2 minutes, and we'll be back. We've got John and Will. They're heading over to the Philippines in a couple weeks from now. And you guys can help out in a couple different ways, so don't go away.